Hey everybody, I'm here to do a much needed update on Mr. Charlie. He is 6 months old, and I'm sorry I haven't updated. It's just, I kept waiting and waiting and waiting for him just to, for me to be able to come on here and say everything is great, and he's not going to need surgery, and I just wanted to be able to say that he's eating good and gaining weight, and it's been months now and I can't say that. So I'm just trying to accept that he's a different baby than he used to be. I keep waiting and waiting for my old Charlie to come back, but I just think he is a different baby and I'm just trying to accept that. But he's so happy and he's like the sweetest baby ever. He is the sweetest baby. He's just a little angel. He is still, as far as heart goes, he is still on all of his heart failure medicine. I'm not sure when they are going to get rid of some of them. I'm sick of them. It's so annoying waking up in the middle of the night and forcing him down him, and then I finally just feed him and then he throws up because of the meds, and it's just such a struggle. It is such a struggle. We hate it. We hate it so much. We kind of feel like we never sleep because we're up with Henry testing blood sugar and checking on him. We're up with Charlie. So we're hoping to get rid of those. We go in for another update, another appointment at the end of the month. So, but as far as like development goes, he's definitely delayed as far as like motor development and stuff. He is 6 months old and he's not even sitting up yet. What else? But he is getting stronger every day. Like, he just started putting weight on his, standing up like this. So he's definitely getting stronger. And he's pulling his head up, you know, like he wants to sit up. Like, he tries to sit up and he kind of topples over. But if you put a toy in front of him, he can kind of sit up. So he is definitely improving. But that's to be expected, delays like that, because he was laying flat in a bed for a whole month with chest tubes. And he was a sick, sick boy. I don't know what else to say. He's just really happy, but it is definitely the hardest thing in the world is feeding him. He's gotten better, like he's gotten his appetite back a little bit, but still doesn't eat like he used to. He hates a bottle. He won't take a bottle. So I'm still nursing him, and then I'm pumping, and I'm like pouring it into the bowl, and then I put it in the fridge, and then all the fat rises to the top. I scrape it off, and then I warm it up, and then I syringe feed him that cream, what we call it. He's not losing weight, but he's not really gaining still. But I don't know, he's not lethargic. I mean, he has tons of energy. He sits in his jumperoo and he bounces and he kicks, and he doesn't roll on the floor yet. And I think, you know, he wasn't able to do tummy time or any of that for so long that he's delayed in that aspect, but he's almost rolling over. What else? He likes to coo and talk, right? And you coo and squeal. He just laughs. He's just so happy. He's so happy. We love him so much. So I don't really know what else to tell you. We don't know whether he's going to need another surgery or not. We just don't know. And that's annoying. It's frustrating not knowing what's going to happen. I mean, he will need another surgery, but when he's way older, because he doesn't have a pulmonary valve, so he's going to need surgery for that. But as far as the hole in his heart, we don't know. We still don't know if he can live with that one or not. His scar is looking awesome. Looks really good. I don't know. There's really not else much to say. We're just struggling with feeding, and that kind of is time consuming, and that's kind of all I think about all day long, every day and night, and weighing him and worrying about his weight. And if I didn't have to worry about his weight and him eating, I think it would be good. Now we go in at the end of the month, and I don't know what we're going to do. We'll see. And I'll do an update then. But thank you for all the support. This community, the mom community, has been so supportive and amazing. And if it was just you guys, I would totally update all the time. But I feel like other moms that have heart babies are not supportive, surprisingly. I feel like I can't really tell you how I'm feeling. As far as him, because the other heart moms out there, or dads, or whoever, They like to just say that, well, you think you got it hard. They tell you their story and like saying how I should be so lucky and because they had it harder or whatever. So that is kind of holding me back from sharing my story anyway, which is surprising because with Henry and type 1 diabetes, I get a lot of negativity from like people who don't really understand or they don't have a child with type 1 or they're kind of don't believe in diabetes, which is ridiculous, or they think there's a cure or that I'm doing something wrong. But the other parents who have children with type 1 are so supportive, and as well as the community here. So it's a lot more fun, and I love sharing our journey with diabetes. But with this heart, with a heart baby, it's definitely more challenging. I just don't like the negativity that I get with. So that's my update. All right. Can you give him a big kiss?